Good morning, guys and gals. This is your host, Joe. It's about 10:20 in the morning. I'm going home this morning, back to Shady Pines. It is already hot. It must be me, you know? I have the air on in the apartment at Shady Pines, and my poor wife is bundled up in blankets with a space heater on under her feet, or we have it where she's comfortable and I am just... I'm thinking I'm in Laughlin in July, and I'm in the middle of the desert. So we certainly are sometimes a mismatched pair. God, I love her, and she's a good woman. She's good people. You know how honorable I use that term. Anyway, I'm going to cruise through Carson City. I'm going to go down to In-N-Out and have breakfast. I've found that having a 3x3 fries, a big iced tea, and coffee kind of gives me enough of the caffeine drug jolt to get me going in the morning. Also, stimulants help manage my ADHD, which is surprising, I guess, if you're not aware of it. And I need to fuel up, and there's a Chevron you saw on the film right around the corner. I'm going to go home 88. I'll stop and film a little bit because it's always a nice ride. Boy, the first time that I rode up 88, I thought, I'm never taking 80 and 50 again. And I've taken 80 to Reno, certainly, but I don't think I've ridden up 50, and I can't tell you how long, because I like going up 88. So that's where we are for now. There's a little bit to talk about, maybe, or maybe not. We'll see. And we'll see what's next. I'm at In-N-Out. Here's my 3x3, my fries that I forgot to ask well because I'm a dummy. The extra large iced tea, the strawberry shake, which is very, very good. My coffee was cold. I'm stunned. I've never took anything back at any In-N-Out ever, but I will not drink cold coffee. So they're brewing me a pot now. I suspect somebody didn't change out the pot from yesterday, but, you know, if that's the worst part of my day, it's going to be a great day. Now, I stopped at Michael's, and you saw this. They had one pair of 4X summer gloves, and there's a little bit of mesh right here. Now, you understand that summer gloves do not have the same protection as thicker, heavier gloves do, but you sacrifice that with some comfort. The gloves that I had are just, I thought that they'd work, and they're off-season gloves. So anyway, I'm going to eat, and we'll press on to see what's next. Well, I'm done here at In-N-Out, and... They brought me coffee eventually. I think they forgot to brew it, and it was yesterday's coffee, and it was cold. So, but you know, they fixed it, and it's actually the first time in the 30 years I've been eating at any In-N-Out that actually longer here it seems to me. Mark and I, and my wife's brother, ex-brother I guess now, stopped at one when we drove down in the early to mid 80s to Los Angeles. Anyway, God, it's already a hot one. It's going to be a slog. I need to get fuel, but I'm going to hook all up right here. Oh, they're offering $15 an hour here at Starry, but remember that Nevada has no state income tax. So you see $18 an hour in California, but, you know, California has a lot more taxation than Nevada. Whether it's worth your taxes or not is certainly an enormous political debate that I'm just not willing to get into probably ever. So there you go. Oh, but it's already a hot one. God, I'm suffering. I'm glad I bought these gloves. I think that they're going to work out well. So I'm going to fuel up, and then we're going to head south on 88, or, well, 395 to 88, and we're going to go all the way to Stockton. So we'll see what's next. Our next stop finds us at the Maverick in Minden, Nevada. Minden is the county seat of Douglas County. I paid $5.83 a gallon for 91. They've got like four different choices of octane. If it showed up on the clip, one of those BMW adventure bikes passed right in front. We used to call them Enduros and then Dual Sports, and you've seen what they've evolved into. It's a pretty crowded market. Everybody has one. Even Harley Davidson started with the Pan American. So I see a lot of these BMWs. I mentioned it in Genoa the other day. So anyway, Maverick is a Western United States, but not west of here, gas and convenience store chain, and they're actually pretty damn good. They always are clean, with clean bathrooms. They've got big soda selection. The staff is invariably nice. I've been to more than one in my travels in Nevada and in Idaho. So, and God knows where else too. I don't remember. I'm old. So, there you go. We're going to press on, and we'll see what's next. Our next stop of the day finds us in Woodford, which is in Alpine County, California, at the terminus of California 4 in the California 88. We're 6 miles north of Markley, Markleyville, the county seat, which I rode through on Friday. I didn't make it out there. I'll make it out there another trip, probably with Rich. We're at the Woodford's General Store Deli Market Cafe. This has been here forever. We're on the old road here, the older road. The seat to my right here, you can hear the traffic by of the new safer and widened 88. The AAA vendor is in Woodford somewhere, but I don't know exactly where. It's not that big of a town. So anyway, this is an interesting stop. I've never really been here except to film and talk like we're going to do now. We're going to press on 88 because I'm having kind of a rough day. And we'll see what's next. Our next stop of the day, about 1:15, and you know, some days it's death by a thousand cuts, or as my wife is sick of me saying, one thing turns into 50. I'm at the top of the Carson Pass. It's 8,500 and something feet. I remembered and now I forgot. I'll add it in here in text. This is the top of a California 88. There's a bathrooms here and a little ranger station. This is a jump off point for a number of hikes up here for people who like to hike and stuff in the hiking season. It's really beautiful up here. God, it's nice, but I'm going to sit for a second because it's a tough one. In Woodford's, the dash cam wouldn't turn on. Now I'm all dressed. I got the music on. I got the bike started, helmet and gloves on, earbuds in. So I have to take my helmet and gloves off, and there's really no place to put the helmet. So I have to take the camera off of the I have to take the attachment off the dash. I have to take the camera off the attachment, and goddamn, a GoPro uses a bolt that's barely longer than half the camera width, and I can't get my fat fingers in there. And then I have to take the media kit off, and then I have to take the battery out. Wait a second. Reverse every one of these steps and see if the camera turns on, which it did. So okay, so now we get up here to Carson Pass. I go to turn the handheld on, and of course it does the same damn thing. It's like, you know, I swear to God, every electronic thing I have just gets gremlins. I have no idea what the problem was. And I noticed when I made that big pass, the bike stumbled twice. So I'm sure, I don't wonder what the hell the problem, maybe I got a bad batch of gas. So I don't know. I am also 8,000 feet up, but it's fuel injected, it shouldn't matter. But nevertheless, we're at, here's the, this big obelisk here was put in by the historical group E. Clampus Vitus. And the clampers, as they call themselves, usually wear red shirts and black pants when they go out and have some type of event. There's also usually a lot of drinking involved. I worked with a guy, one of the supervisors, who bluntly he tried to get rid of me more than once and wasn't successful. So don't think I don't remember you. I won't name you by name, but I don't think that I don't celebrate every day that I outlasted you and every one of these other sons of bitch and supervisors and thought that they were gonna deny me my pension and my health insurance. And the one Dayside Teamster that tried to get all the health insurance to take it away, I had to tell him that it was gonna be trouble. That he may want to reevaluate this. I won't say exactly what I said because I'm on film, but it didn't happen, and I have health insurance, so there you go. The Clampers sound like an interesting group, but, you know, I don't drink, and, you know, drunken older men don't really, you know, I'm just too old for this shit now. Anyway, but they do good historical things, and like the obelisk here, you know, God love them, they... For whatever other stuff that they do put up a lot of historical plaques and markers and stuff, and I really appreciate that, because I think our history should be told, the good and the bad. There was a case a couple of years ago where the Clampers, and there were Clampers who were working for the for San Quentin. They drug out some old cannon and blew it off the either on the prison grounds or right next to the prison grounds. And there was a lot of hoobaloo about that. So they're an interesting group, but I don't really know any of them now. They do some good things, and I'm happy about that. So this is your almost 5-minute babbling. I'm going to sit up here. I'm going to use my cold water. I'm going to wipe myself down. There's a fire near Yosemite. And the smoke is blown all the way up here. And the National Weather Service even gave a warning about the heat and the smoke. So it is really going to be a long one today. But nevertheless, 5 minutes and 10 seconds plus a babbling. And we'll see what's next.